Good evening and welcome to Exposé. This evening we'll be chatting with Gamal Doyle, also known as Skinny Fabulous. Good evening, Gamal, and welcome to Exposé.
Okay, greetings to you, Maleeka, and greetings to St Vincent and the Grenadines.
Okay, tell us, who is Skinny Fabulous?
Okay, basically that's me, and I'm a local dancehall artist hoping to pursue my music in St Vincent and beyond, regionally and internationally. Okay, that's me.
Okay, where did you get the name Skinny Fabulous?
Well, if you look carefully, I can say that's self-explanatory. The skinny part, of course. Yes, I'm very skinny. The fabulous cannot be seen visually at first glance, but then once you get to know me, I can say that I'm fabulous. So that's Skinny Fabulous.
When did you start singing?
Okay, well, I started singing about from junior five, and that was my own songs. That was singing basically people's songs, Crisscross, Buju Banton. That was in primary school, knocking on the desks and stuff. Yeah, basically, that's where I started. But publicly, I would say I started about Farm Tree. That's when I started performing in shows, like school shows and Convent America, talent shows and all over the place, basically.
As a young local artist, what are some of the difficulties that you are faced with?
Okay, I have several here. First, as a local artist, I'm met with negative forces from other local artists. It is supposed to be we collaborate and make this thing work, but most times the other local artists, for some strange reason, they look to fight you down. Well, not all of them, but some of them look to fight you down, either to get a piece of the pie or whatever the case may be. The second difficulty basically was getting airplay at first. Now it's a bit cool, it's a bit better, but at first the radio station had a little skepticalism in them to play my music, basically. But now everything is cool.
How did you feel about your performance at the Junior Kelly show?
Okay, the performance at the Junior Kelly show, it was by far different from the norm. It was a surprise to me, it was a surprise to St. Vincent. Basically, it was disappointed, but hopefully it will be a stepping stone for me, because if things hadn't turned out the way they did, then there would be no mistake to learn from. So I would see it as an obstacle that has been, well, not yet, but to be overcome in the future, and there would be proactive measures in place to see that those sort of things don't happen again. Basically, the performance that the people got, right? Me personally, I would say that I was overconfident, hence there was a lack of preparation. So it was just an impromptu sort of thing. Hence, things just got into its own hands, not really mine, not really people's. It just let loose, you know? But I'm solid, I'm humble now, and hopefully things will turn out better.
So your fans can be assured that such a performance will not occur in the future?
Yes, definitely.
You recently released your album, Skinny Fabulous, First Strike. What was the public's response to this album?
Well, we got a very successful response. As aspired, we were planning to attain a standard of what I call Vinci Platinum. And we actually got through. Now, Vinci Platinum is like 100, eh? So, and 100 copies, in order to get local artists, it may sound easy, but it's actually not. Because, as you know, we as Vincentians, we are sort of hard to penetrate. So, 100 copies being sold to our own local Vincentians, I would say that's successful. To me, that's my level of success, okay, because not many artists can produce an album and even get 10 sold to their own friends. So I'm happy, I'm contented with the success and the result of the album, basically.
Okay, and what are your plans for the future in terms of your singing career?
Okay, first I must say that before I was genuinely and 100% hardcore dancehall. So as far as future plans goes, it means that I'll be changing the angle. I will not only be singing for the few people in front of the stage, but for the whole audience in general. Now, in terms of plans, I'm trying to do some marketing outside of St. Vincent, and hopefully that will come true, and it's beginning to show some light.
Thank you, Mr. Fabulous, for being a part of our show, and I want to wish you all the best in your musical career.
Okay, thank you, and I wish me all the best also.
Okay, this has been another edition of Exposé. I'm Maleeka Joseph.
Lockout drugs are locked in.